Hey folks, welcome to Quantsapp and welcome back to another video. If trading volatile markets is a nightmare for you, then this video is for you. You should check out this video till the very end, because in this video, we will understand the do's and the don'ts. What are the things you should do in volatile markets and what all are the things you should not do in volatile markets. So do check out the video till the very end, because in volatile markets, a lot of option traders, they lose a big chunk to errors. So if they are losing a big chunk, someone is making a big chunk, right? So in this video, let's try to understand all those steps which are, you know, necessary for us to validate our option trades when we are trading in volatile markets. So first do is check the expected rise or drop in implied volatility based on event analysis. So now what exactly that means? So that means that you just need to check, or I would say you just need to approximate the implied volatility increase and decrease because of any major event. Okay, so let's do it. So if you go to IV suit, okay, so, and if you go to IV chart, so results are one of the most, it is a global phenomena that is actively traded by a lot of option traders. So, you know, typically before the results, the IVs, they start to go up, and once the results are out, the implied volatility collapses. And another thing about implied volatility is it takes up your call and put option both. And if the IVs collapse, they take down your call and put option both. So now what you need to do is you just need to check that, okay, in ITC, typically, let's say 30% is the jump in implied volatility that happens. Okay. It might be less, it might be more here and there, and it will also differ for stock to stock. But what you need to do is, let's say you are creating a trade on ITC before the result. What you need to do, you just need to check that, okay, in some instance, it has the IV, if you see, it has gone up from what, 14 to almost 28, right? In this case, so the IVs have doubled in this case, but in this case, it has not doubled, but it has witnessed a significant jump in implied volatility. So what you need to do, you just need to understand that, okay, generally 30% IV jump happens in ITC before results, and after the results, generally implied volatility goes down by, let's say, 30%. You just need to approximate it. Okay. You don't need to go ahead and calculate the exact figure. You just need to approximate it. Okay. So now what will you do after approximating it? Whatever strategy you are deploying, let's say you are creating a long call. Okay. A simple plain vanilla call option in ITC. What you need to do, you just give input about the implied volatility. If you see T plus N PNL on this zone, okay. If you just see the T plus N PNL, which is zero. Okay, today, if you see at the same level ITC, this long call will give you absolutely no profit, no loss. But if the IV go up by, let's say 50%, you see at the same level, you might end up making a profit of what? 4,871. Okay, similarly, you can do it for any option strategy. You can build any option strategy and you can give input about the implied volatility. If it is before the result, you give inputs that, okay, you are expecting so much jump in implied volatility. If it is after the result, you expect so much drop in implied volatility, and check if that strategy still makes sense for you to, you know, go ahead and initiate. And who knows, you might just avoid the strategy where you would have lost to error. So that is the first do for the day, which is check the expected increase or decrease. Okay, check the expected increase or decrease in implied volatility. Okay. So let's jot it down. Okay. So check in IV increase and decrease pre and post the results, and just give input to the architect about your strategy and just simulate the effect. Now coming to the second point for the day. Okay. So the second do for the day is stick to the right strategy in high volatility versus low volatility. So if you just look at this graph, okay. So if you just look at this graph of ITC, there are some zones when the implied volatility was really, really low, and some zones where implied volatility was really, really high. So, you know, one thing we know, all know about implied volatility is that IVs, they are mean reverting. If they are at bottom, they will spike up. If they are at top, they will cool down. Okay. So if implied volatility is low, you should generally opt for buying options. Okay. Typically, you should opt for buying options because the premiums will be cheap. Second thing is, you will get implied volatility benefit as well. Okay. So what I mean by this is, So I have created long straddle. I have bought call and put options both. So I'll just toggle with the tabular views for us to understand it better. So if you just look at this T plus N PNL over here, at the same level, 36.17, we are making a profit of what? 15 rupees at the same level. You know, if the IV is exactly over here, but if the IV go up, let's say by 30%, see, same level pay, you are getting a profit of 5,384. So now what we need to really do is, you just need to pick up a right strategy considering the where you are placed on implied volatility curve. So if what you need to do to identify it, just look at this chart. If the IVs are spiked up, which means the IV is high. If the IVs, if you find this yellow line, the implied volatility line at the bottom zone, that means the implied volatility is low. So, you know, you need to do it in that way. Second thing is, if the IVs are high, you should convert your strategies into spreads. Now, why I mean spread is because implied volatility will, if it collapses, it will take down your call and put premium both. So let's say if on this day, if you buy any option, okay, let's say you buy a put option on this day, despite, you know, ITC has collapsed, you would have not made enough profits because the IVs have collapsed like anything. So what you will do, you will create a strategy, you will create a spread. That means if you are bullish, you can create something like a bull call spread, so that, you know, you have two options over here, you have two legs over here. So the first is that you have bought. So if the IVs collapse, it will collapse from this option as well. And even the IVs will collapse from this sold option as well. Okay, so I have sold one option, which is a bull call spread. I have bought one and I have sold one. So what is happening in this case? I am losing money from here, right? I am losing money from here, but that loss is getting offsetted by the second leg. Okay. It is getting offsetted. So you can typically consider spreads depending on your view. Let's say if the IVs are at top, you can consider, and if you have a bullish view, a bull call spread would be a strategy. If you have a bearish view, a bear put spread would be a strategy. If you are completely non-directional directional on that case, you know, selling call and put options would be also one of the strategies which we will discuss ahead. Okay. So the second point that we understand is, so let's jot it down. So the second point is that choose the right strategy. Okay. Choose the right strategy for low and high IV conditions. Okay. So this is the second do's what you should do. Now coming to the third do, what is the thing what you should do when you are trading in volatile market? Have a proper exit strategy before entering. Now, you know, a lot of us, we focus a lot on our entries. We spend a lot of time where we will enter our trade when, but we don't really have an exit plan. So have an exit plan, you know, for your option strategies whenever you are entering it. Now, what I mean by this is, so if you see ITC, typically till results, the IVs keep on going up, right? And once the results are out, the implied volatility collapses. Now, the simplest strategy over here is, you be on buying side of options till the result day. I'm talking about ITC. This will differ from stock to stock. Okay, so over here, if you see before the results, the IVs are going up. So I can consider being option buyer in this case. But you know, the moment results are out, I can exit my buy trades. By buy, I don't mean any direction forecast on ITC, but at least I can stop buying options or convert them in spreads. So I know if I'm creating, let's say, a trade on this day, which is 13th of May, when the IV is 29.4, I know that, okay, result is going to get announced on 18th of May. What I will do, I will exit. If I have bought options in this case, let's say I have created a straddle. Okay, so let's keep it very simple that on this day, I created a straddle in expectation of IV going up. What I will do, the moment results are out, I will go ahead and exit. So I know where I'm going to exit my strategy. On this day itself, I know that on result day, which is 18th of May, once the results are out of ITC, or even, you know, or specifically on that day itself, I can exit the strategy, because that is what happened in ITC historically, right? So this is what, and even on this result, if you see, once the results are out, from that very day itself, the IVs collapse. So that is the simple thing what you can do. You need to go ahead and have an exit plan for your strategy. So what could be your exit plan? Buying options stops on the result day. After that, selling options starts, right? So this is the thing. Or spreads, you can convert it into spreads, and that is something what you can do. So third point is, which is have an exit plan for your option strategy. Okay, so a lot of people have entry, but have a right exit plan. So now let's understand the do's. So we understood all the do's, what are the things you should do, but these are the things which are really, really important. These are the things what you should not do when you are trading options in volatile market conditions. So to start off with, selling options without protection. Don't go ahead and randomly sell options just because you are getting a higher premium. Okay, but that also does not mean you should not sell options. Do it, but do it with a protection. But why? Because if I just show you one simple strategy, okay, so just look at this. This is a short straddle on ITC, selling call and put options both. It has undefined loss, right? If you sell naked call and put both, you will have undefined losses on both the side. Instead, what you can do is you can convert that strategy into spread, right? Just buy the wings, just buy the hedges. So in this case, what I have done, there is a straddle. I have bought more legs to protect it so that, you know, I am not facing undefined loss. There is a loss there. I am facing a loss of 4,640, but that is capped. There is no undefined loss. If you see at the top, at the peak, I am getting 10,000 rupees profit. What is the loss I'm making? 4,600, which is fine. So the first thing that you will not do is selling options, okay, without hedge, okay? Don't write options without an edge, okay? Because a big move might just take you out of the game. So now coming to the second point, which you should not do when you are actually going ahead and trading volatile market conditions, is buying options without time stop loss. Now, what does that mean? That means that, you know, if I just open this long straddle, which we have created, okay? So let's just keep the IVs normal to zero. Okay, so let's keep the IVs normal. So if I just see that this straddle is giving me a profit every day, okay, everywhere, which is zero, which is today EOD. But you know, if I just move the day slider to 3 days, see everywhere I am making a loss. From 357 to 367, I am making a loss, right? If I hold it more, okay, I hold it beyond it. So if I see, if I held this strategy till 7 days from here, I am making a loss from what? 353. Up to the level of 370, right? So basically what does that mean is, just don't go ahead and buy options because just you're thinking that market might move here and there, or just go, don't go ahead and buy, randomly buy options, because the only thing might go against you in that case is the time is. So the second point is, avoid buying options, okay, without a time stop loss. So what would be a time stop loss in this case? That you know, in some cases there would be 2 days, some cases there might be 3 days. It depends on where you are placed on the expiry curve. Identify the sweet, you know, spot where you should exit this strategy. Now the last thing is carrying options through the event without doing any impact analysis. Now what does that mean? That means that if you go ahead and buy option or sell options or create any strategy, and if you don't do any impact analysis, most likely is the chance that you will lose a big chunk to the error, and the error is not doing any, you know, implied volatility analysis, not doing any impact analysis. So whatever strategy you're doing, just do a small impact analysis of implied volatility on your option strategy and you would be good to go. So the last step that we understood was, do, you know, not doing impact analysis, okay? And one cheat code over here is, do all of the above. Okay, matlab, for do's, you have to do all of it, and don'ts, just avoid it. So that is the thing. And if you want, you can take a screenshot of it and you can stick this to your wall. So yes, traders, that was it from my side. Thank you so much for staying tuned along with me up till here. If you have liked this video, do with the like button, do with the subscribe button, and also comment down below what is the next video you want us to discuss on.